Good morning. I want to welcome you back again to Central Baptist Church Sunday School Hour. And I want to thank all of you who joined us last week and the week before. I did hear from some of you, and I'm very thankful for that. I praise the Lord that we're not only children listening, there were some parents as well. And I want to just praise the Lord today for this opportunity again and to share with you some Sunday school lessons that might be an encouragement to you. First of all, this is a very important Sunday that we're celebrating, and it has a lot to do with, of course, the Lord Jesus Christ, because it was on a Sunday that he rose from the dead. And last week we talked about the crucifixion, and this morning I want to go a little bit over a little bit of that information as well. But we're going to start with, first of all, I want to mention a few names. I told them I would. First of all, Carol Lee, I want to say hi. And that's my granddaughter, and they listen every week. And then I want to thank Titus and also Christopher and trying to think of some other names that told me that they did watch. And I just want to thank them for doing so. And we thank you for watching. And want to welcome all of you. Some people maybe they aren't even moms and dads. I know we're listening, wanting to know what's going on. We always have our Bibles with us on Sunday. So I hope that you have your Bible with you. If you haven't already got it, if you'll go back and get it. But today we're going to start off with a word of prayer, because I want us to be able to focus on what the Lord has for us. So let's just bow our heads in prayer and talk to the Lord. Our Heavenly Father, thank you so much for this opportunity to come today. I pray that you might help me as the teacher to speak just the words that you'd have me to say. Help me to be clear, Lord. And I pray that you might be with those who are listening, especially the children, that it might speak to their hearts and help them to know how to apply it. And Father, we want to thank you again for this resurrection day, where we can come and praise you for who you are, what you've done for us, and Lord, what we can expect in the future. And we'll give you the praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, I hope you've got your Bibles by now. But before we begin with the Word of God, I want to tell you what Easter is and the difference between Easter and resurrection. First of all, Easter is not really a Christian holiday, although we do celebrate it because the churches did incorporate it in the 1700s. It started with, and I'm going to get my prop here, the Easter Bunny. The Easter Bunny was supposed to be representative of a way of rewarding children for being good. And so the Easter Bunny would come with a basket of eggs. And even today we celebrate Easter. This bunny does not want to stay seated. I guess she's tired. But anyway, the Easter Bunny would come, deliver eggs, and have you ever been on an Easter egg hunt? I know my children used to go on Easter egg hunts, and every Easter morning, they would see a basket of fruit or eggs and candy, and we would celebrate it that way too. But this is truly not what Easter Sunday is about for us in the church. We want to talk more about what it means according to the Bible. And so we have here this word. It's a long word. I don't know if you can spell it, but it's resurrection. And it means to be risen up. Now, it's a wonderful thing when we realize that Jesus was fulfilling his promise when he told us in John 19:10. Do you remember the verse that we had last week? It was, "For the Son of Man is come to seek and to save that which was lost." John 19:10. Well, Jesus was not only the Son of Man because he had an earthly mother, but he was also the Son of God. And because God cannot die, he became a man in order to die. That was how he could save us. And we're going to talk more about what that means in just a moment. But all of us are born lost. That means we are apart from God, and he is seeking us to know him. Today, I want you to, I'm going to read to you some verses from Luke chapter 23. And if you remember, last week we talked about the crucifixion, how Jesus did die for us. But here in this picture, you can see that Jesus wasn't the only one who died on that day. There were two other men that were crucified along with him. And that's very important because I want you to see that today you are representative of one of, or the other of these thieves, and they were thieves. Whether they really deserve to be crucified along with Christ, I don't know. But I do know this, God allowed it to happen, and it certainly is an example to you and I. You know, everybody's got their own opinion, and these two thieves had their opinion about Jesus. And that your opinion about Jesus is very important. It could mean whether you go to heaven or whether you are separated from God forever in a place that you don't want to go to. And I'm going to read some verses to you from Luke chapter 23, starting with verse 32. And there were also two other malefactors led with him to be put to death. And when they were come to the place which is called Calvary, there they crucified him, and the malefactors, one on the right hand and the other on the left. Now, these malefactors were crucified the very same way that Jesus was, except he was nailed to the cross, and they were tied to the cross. And in here we see that one of the malefactors said to Jesus something that a lot of people feel like today. He said in verse 39 of chapter 23 of Luke, he says, and one of the malefactors which were hanged railed on him. That means he was angry. He was not very happy with Jesus. And he said, if thou be Christ. He was questioning God. He said, if thou be Christ, save thyself and us. Wow, he had heard already that Jesus had come to seek and to save the lost. But for some reason, he just didn't believe it. He wanted Jesus to come off the cross and save him right then and there. But the other answering rebuked him, saying, dost thou not fear God, seeing thou art in the same condemnation? And we indeed justly, for we receive the due reward of our deeds, but this man hath done nothing amiss. And he said unto Jesus, Lord, remember me when thou comest into thy kingdom. That's two complete opposite opinions. One of the thieves did not believe that Jesus could save him. The other thief did believe that Jesus could save him. He said, Lord, remember me when you enter into your kingdom. Well, if Jesus had come off the cross, can you tell me, why would that not have worked? Well, I want to show you why that would not have worked. There's a verse in the Bible that tells us something very important. Lazarus had died, and Lazarus' sisters were grieving because Jesus had, if he had come, they thought that Jesus could have saved him from dying. He had saved others from dying. But he was late in coming. And Martha came up to Jesus and she said, Lord, if you'd have just been here, he would not have died. But Jesus said unto her, I am the resurrection and the life. He that believeth in me, though he were dead, yet shall he live. He was talking about Lazarus and anyone else that had died believing in him. And whosoever liveth, that's you and me today too, and believeth in me, shall never die. And then he asked her a question. Believest thou this? Oh, that must have really touched her heart because she really did believe, but she was grieving for her brother who had died. Have you ever lost a loved one, someone that you really wanted to see again? And there was Jesus. And he could have done it, but he didn't come. Well, Jesus had a reason for not coming when he said he would come. You know, when Jesus, he had to die. If he had come off of the cross when the thief wanted him to, then Jesus would have disobeyed his heavenly Father, and he would not have been able to save anybody. He would have been condemned himself, maybe. I don't know how that would work. No, he was God, so he would never have done it anyway. And so in order for Jesus to rise up again, he had to die. He had to die for you and for me. So Jesus did die on the cross. And Joseph of Arimathea allowed Jesus to be put in his grave. And he had him wrapped up so that he could not move, even if he was alive. Some people claim that Jesus wasn't dead, he just swooned. Well, that couldn't be, because Jesus definitely was wrapped up so well and put in a tomb. And then, you know what they did? They put him in a tomb and rolled a stone that was very heavy. It took several to put it there. And so they didn't want someone to come to steal his body and say that he had risen from the dead. So here are the soldiers that were put out to guard it, to keep people away. And so it was so secure that no one could get in. Well, that didn't stop Jesus, did it? Because he is the Son of God. And we celebrate Resurrection Day because Jesus came out of the tomb on the first day of the week. The Bible says he rose again on the third day after his death. And when he did, the soldiers fell backwards and they fainted because of it. And the angels were proclaiming that Jesus had risen from the dead. And here we see that the ladies that came to mourn him and to put spices on his body, they were asking the question, how shall we roll, who's going to roll away the stone for us that we might get there? They were so, so unhappy. But when they got there, the stone had already been rolled away. Wow, they were pretty excited. And then they went and told Peter and John and the rest of the disciples, and they came to look too. They were all so happy that Jesus was not there, that he had risen from the dead. But you know, they had not really, really remembered all that Jesus had said. And then Mary was weeping outside. She had thought that perhaps the gardener was coming up, and she looked and she said, where have you taken my Lord? I will, so that we can put spices on his body. And he said one word. He said, Mary, and she knew it was Jesus. You know, Jesus said that to me one time. He said, Linda, and I knew it was him speaking to me. And I knew that my Lord was alive. He is alive. He's not dead. And I'm so thankful that Jesus went to the cross like he said he would do, and that he died on the cross so that I could have everlasting life. I do believe. Now, the question Jesus asked them was, believest thou this? So, remember the two thieves? One said, come off the cross and save yourself and us. But Jesus knew he couldn't do that. But the other thief said, Lord, remember me when you enter into your kingdom. And I want to read to you from Luke chapter 23. And verse 43, and this is what Jesus said to him. He said, verily I say unto thee, today shalt thou be with me in paradise. Oh, wasn't that exciting? That thief, when he died, he was with Jesus. Jesus had already died, and the thief, when he died, was right there with Jesus in paradise. You and I can have that assurance of salvation too. The Bible tells us that Jesus is the resurrection and the life. It doesn't matter if you believe in Jesus and you die. My husband is with the Lord, but I know that he is no longer dead, really. He is alive, and one day I'm going to see him again. And my mother and my grandmother and my uncle and even my dad is in heaven. And my stepfather, there are so many people, my aunts and uncles, people that I love and know, and they answered this question, believest thou this? And they said yes. How about you? Jesus is asking you that question today. Do you believe that He is the resurrection and the life? He says that if you do believe, then you're going to live forever. And I am so thankful to know that some of you are saved and that you have received Him as your Savior. However, perhaps there's someone listening today and you've never received Christ as your Savior. All you have to do is believe. You have to know, first of all, that you're a sinner, that Jesus died on the cross, and that He did it because He came to seek and to save that which was lost, and that He loves you. He knows you by name. And one day, if you accept Him as Savior, He's calling your name. And He wants you to know Him personally as His Lord and Savior. And then all you have to do is repent of your sin. You see, your sin separates you from God. And He paid the price when He died on the cross. And when He rose again, He gave us the privilege. You know, what was the definition of that word, resurrection? To be risen up. If He could not have risen from the grave Himself, how could He raise you and me? He couldn't. And that's why Jesus had to go to the cross, why He died, so that you and I would have the assurance of a resurrection. And one day we will be raised to life anew in Christ Jesus with Him. And so I want us to bow our heads. And right now I just want you to think for a minute. I want you to just say, Dear Lord, if you're saved, I want you to thank Him for saving you. If you're not saved, I want you to just think and realize that you are a sinner and that if you died without Christ, you would not go to heaven. Do you believe that He's the resurrection and the life? If you do, then I want you to invite Him into your life and to save you. Just ask Him and He will come in. Let's pray. Our Heavenly Father, we thank You that You are the resurrection and the life. Thank You that we don't have to celebrate Easter. We can celebrate the resurrection. And Lord, it's such a joy to know that if anyone would just believe, You're asking them if they believe, and if they do, then I know, Lord, that You'll come into their heart and their life and save them. Father, thank You for dying on the cross to save us from our sin. Thank You for raising from the dead that we might have everlasting life. And we give You all the praise, all the glory, for we ask it in Jesus' name. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us today. I appreciate you listening. And if there's somebody out there that has accepted Christ as their Savior today, I would love to hear from you. You can email us at the church at mail@centralbaptistchurch.com or .net. Is it .net? Excuse me. centralbaptistchurch.net. And then be sure and be listening next week at the same, whenever you want to listen on the YouTube channel. We just want you to join us as we talk some more about the joys of being a Christian and the purpose for the resurrection. Thank you. Goodbye. See you next week.